we the last to arrive?
I hope we've not kept you waiting.
Not at all. Your comrade is feeling better, I trust.
Much better, thank you. Harness remedies are certainly potent in more ways than one.
One becomes accustomed to the taste, although I hope you never have cause to do so. Pray, take your ease.
Full glad I am to see you all unharmed.
Valiant Scions, for your heroism, you have my boundless gratitude. You cast down that dire tower and set free its hapless captives. You cleanse their souls of its corrupting influence. No words of thanks will suffice. In place of platitudes, I offer a bounty of warding scales. Pray accept your due reward, along with the goodwill of Razatan.
Alchemists throughout the land were put to work in the forging of your talismans. The finished ones have been collected, and now await you at the High Crucible of Alchemia. Present this letter when you are ready to take them into your possession.
We are humbled by your generosity. Know that the inventive wisdom of Razatan will be vital in restoring serenity to our star.
Every single one of those scales came from you, didn't they? You must still be in such pain.
Tis of no moment. A mere annoyance compared to the dreadful suffering inflicted upon this land and its people.
Albeit brief, my involvement in the Dragonsong War afforded me a glimpse of the myriad sorrows which consumed both dragon and man. Though you were half a world away, such tragedies as befell your kin must have affected you deeply. And yet, you chose to live among men.
In the age when that conflict first bloomed, my choice had already been made. In some distant place, man slew dragon, and dragon slaughtered man. Yet no hate could I muster for those smiling faces which did look to me for guidance. Not even my brother's righteous rage could rally me to his cause. I huddled here, secret and still, hoping against hope that which I had built would remain untouched by the chaos and carnage.
T'would seem we share the same desire for peace, great Vritra. To that end, I wonder if we might trouble you with another question. The Teloferoi are intent on recreating the final days, an apocalyptic event which we know to predate the sundering of the star. As the longest lived among us, know you aught of this terrible cataclysm?
Nay. When war and strife drove my sire from his home, he crossed the great expanse with only our unhatched eggs as company. He alighted upon a shattered source, Its 13 reflections long since scattered beyond the rift. Of events preceding his arrival, he knoweth naught, save that which Hydralin hath deigned to disclose.
I see. So again, 'tis the inscrutable Hydralin to whom you must look for answers.
Seek you to divine the will of this star? If so, I have a tale which may afford you some small comfort. Tis a story from my youth, many, many years ago. To my sire, I once posed the question, of all the stars in the sky, why didst thou settle upon this one? To which Midgardsummer did reply, 'twas the last bastion of hope. He believed, so long as Hydralin endured, so too might dragonkind. Solemn and portentous were his words. What deeper meaning they held, I could not, dared not pursue. 'Tis a stone I've left unturned ever since. Yet take you solace in the knowledge that whatsoever Hydralin does strive towards, 'tis an ideal which hath earned my sire's conviction.
Thank you, Vritra. You've given us warm reassurance in a world gripped by cold uncertainty.
While I'm sure we all have a great many questions, I think it's time we collect the talismans and be on our way. Our fight against the Talophoroi is far from finished.
We must take our leave. But please do inform us if we can provide any further assistance.
Prithee, a moment. There is one whom my sire hath judged worthy of honor and respect. The one known to men as Eorzea's champion. This hero of renown and rumor, 'tis thee. I know of his clash with Omega, and the long slumber which was his price. Yet even closed in sleep, my father's eyes are far from blind. He is watching over thee, watching over this world. T'was a revelation most pleasing that thou, a child of man, had gained Midgardsummer's trust, but alongside mine elation runneth a rivulet of dread. For upon thy life's reel wind too many threads of fate, power, weal enmeshed with woe. Amidst this tangled knot thou shalt know no rest. 'Tis an endless confluence of forces, a struggle without surcease. More terrible still is the attrition wrought upon thy companions, as they are swept up in the storm of thine existence. Even cowering behind my curtain, I know the suffering of the powerful. I have watched my siblings driven mad by loss. Thus do I exhort thee to spare no effort to keep thy loved ones safe.
Ah, apologies. We hadn't meant to interrupt.
It's just that we do have a history of suddenly collapsing, and when you didn't follow us out...
Tis I who must apologize. I have detained your champion overlong with idle chatter. Go. At war's end, I pray I welcome thee back into my hall, where together with thy joyful comrades, you may toast your triumph.